बारको इंडिया रिकॉग्नाइज्ड एज ग्रेट प्लेस टू वर्क। बारको इंडिया हैज़ बीन रिकॉग्नाइज्ड एज अ ग्रेट प्लेस टू वर्क द सेकेंड ईयर इन अ रो बाय ग्रेट प्लेस टू वर्क इंस्टीट्यूट। It has received a high score on the trust index, which reflects the company's focus on people as a core area of strength. The evaluation is based on the audit of a company's HR practices and policies, as well as anonymous feedback from employees on the organization culture. Abu Dhabi Sheikh invests $1 billion Lulu Group, an investment firm backed by a member of Abu Dhabi's royal family, agreed to buy a stake worth just over $1 billion in Lulu Group International. The company led by Sheikh Tahnoon Biz Zayed Al Nahyan acquired an almost 20% holding in the Abu Dhabi based supermarket group founded by Indian entrepreneur Yusuf Ali. UNODC launched a series of online dialogues. The United Nations Office on Drugs and Crimes, UNODC, has launched a Lockdown Learners series of online dialogues with students and educators in India. The dialogue is on COVID-19 and its impact on sustainable development goals, peace and rule of law. The aim is to sensitize students on concerns of vulnerable groups and emerging issues such as cybercrime, misinformation, etc. A woman developed 10 varieties of Anthurium. D. Vasini Bai, a woman innovator from Thiruvananthapuram, has developed 10 varieties of Anthurium, a flower with high market value by cross-pollination. Anthurium is a vast group of beautiful blooming plants available in a wide range of colors. Anthurium is one of the best domestic flowering plants in the world. They also purify the surrounding air and remove harmful airborne chemicals. Air pollution levels at 20-year low, NASA. Air pollution over northern India has plummeted to a 20-year low for this time of 2020. According to satellite data published by NASA, the data published with maps show aerosol optical depth AOD in 2020 compared to the average for 2016 to 2019. Aerosol optical depth is a measure of how light is absorbed or reflected by airborne particles as it travels through the atmosphere. Lebanon legalized cannabis farming. Lebanese legislators have approved a law legalizing the cultivation of cannabis for medicinal and industrial use. The decision, which makes Lebanon the first Arab country to legalize marijuana growing, offers economic incentives for that region state. It makes the state the sole proprietor for trading cannabis, which has been grown illicitly for decades in Beka. Rakesh Sharma, new president of IMMA, the International Motorcycle Manufacturers Association. has appointed Bajaj Auto Executive Director ED Rakesh Sharma as its president. Sharma had been previously holding office as vice president in IMMA, elected in May 2019. He succeeds Johannes Lohmann, director of PT Astra International TBK and executive vice president director PT Astra Honda Motor Indonesia. English Language Day, 23rd April. English Language Day is a United Nations observance that people celebrate on April 23 each year. The day aims to entertain and inform people about the history, culture, and achievements associated with the language. The UN first celebrated English Language Day on April 23, 2010. English is one of the two working languages of the UN Secretariat. TCS to power Israel's first fully digital bank. Tata Consultancy Services will launch Israel's first fully digital bank. TCS was selected by Israel's Ministry of Finance to transform its banking sector by building a banking service bureau that would serve as a shared plug-and-play digital banking operations platform. This initiative is seen as a bid to boost competition in the financial services sector and enhance the customer experience. Pulse's oil seeds worth rupees 1,313 crore procured. NAFED and Food Corporation of India have procured pulses and oil seeds worth rupees 1,313 crore, benefiting more than 1,74,000 farmers. The Department of Agriculture, Cooperation and Farmers Welfare is taking several measures to facilitate the farmers and farming activities at the field level. Procurement of pulses and oil seeds on MSP is currently in progress in 20 states during Rabi season 2020. JKSLSA launched a helpline. Jammu and Kashmir State Legal Services Authority has launched a helpline under Serve the Senior Initiative, Seniors Initiatives. The objective of starting this helpline is to help and facilitate senior citizens who live alone and are unable to step out to get medicines, groceries and other essentials for Jammu. One can contact Nausad Ahmed Khan on 9622-283677 or Sandeep Kaur on 9419223000. Government sanctioned rupees 15,000 crore investment. The Union Cabinet gave its post facto approval for significant investments of rupees 15,000 crore for India COVID-19 emergency response and health system preparedness package. The fund sanction will be utilized in three phases. Out of the total amount, rupees 7,774 crore has been provisioned for immediate COVID-19 emergency response. Fixation of nutrient-based subsidy rates. The Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs, CCEA, gave its approval for fixation of nutrient-based subsidy, NBS rates for phosphatic and potassic P&K fertilizers for the year 2020-21. The approved rates for NBS will be 18 rupees 78 paise per kg for nitrogen, 14 rupees 88 paise per kg for phosphorus, 10 rupees 11 paise per kg for potash and 2 rupees 37 paise per kg for sulfur. HRD minister launched Vidya Dan 2.0. HRD minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank has launched national program Vidya Dan 2.0 for inviting e-learning content contributions in New Delhi. It has been launched due to the increasing requirement for e-learning content for students in both school and higher education. It is a common national program to develop and contribute e-learning content and a chance to be recognized nationally. India handed over medicines to Nepal. Ambassador of India to Nepal, Vinay Mohan Quatra, handed over 23 tons of medicines to Nepal's Minister for Health and Population, Bhanu Bhakta Dhakal, in Kathmandu on 22nd April 2020. The consignment includes 8.25 lakhs doses of essential medicines, including 3.2 lakhs doses of paracetamol and 2.5 lakhs doses of hydroxychloroquine. Epidemic Diseases Act 1897 to be amended. President Ram Nath Kovind has given assent for the promulgation of the ordinance to amend the Epidemic Diseases Act 1897 to protect the healthcare services service personnel. The ordinance provides for making acts of violence cognizable and non-bailable offenses and for compensation for injury to healthcare service personnel. Violence will include harassment and physical injury and damage to property. Adam Higginbotham won William E. Colby Award. Adam Higginbotham's Midnight in Chernobyl, the untold story of the world's greatest nuclear disaster, has won a $5,000 prize. Higginbotham has received the William E. Colby Award given for an outstanding book on military or intelligence history. The Colby Award was established in 1999. Previous winners include Karl Marlant, Noel Matterhorn, and Dexter Filkins, The Forever War. PV Sindhu, ambassador for an awareness campaign. PV Sindhu has been unveiled as one of the ambassadors for Badminton World Federation, BWF's I Am Badminton awareness campaign. The campaign provides a platform for players to express their love and respect for badminton by advocating and committing to clean and honest play. Besides Sindhu, other ambassadors include Michael Lee Zheng, C.V. Huang Ya Kong, Jack Safford, to name a few. Gujarat government's water conservation scheme began. Gujarat CM has given the green signal for the third edition of Sujalam Suflam Jal Sanchay Abhiyan. It is a conservation plan to deepen water bodies in the state before the monsoon. The scheme, which will continue till June 10, 2020, will see the deepening of lakes, check dams and rivers by removing silt, and it will be done with people's participation as well as under MNREGA. Production of COVID-19 testing kits started. A South Korean firm has started production of the COVID-19 rapid antibody testing kits in its Indian subsidiary plant. It will meet the growing demand of medical equipment in India and other parts of the world. Its Indian subsidiary is located in Manesar, Gurgaon. It is producing test kits with a capacity of 5 lakh tests per week, and the first batch was rolled out on April 19, 2020. Thank you. Please comment and subscribe the channel, like and share the video. Thank you. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.